My magnolia trees really blooming nicely. The yard also is still filling in nicely and looking good. But I want to talk about something else today, and it involves getting on my laptop. So let's chat. Some of the comments on the videos point out the fact that a lot of the stuff that I've covered apply only to warm season grasses, and that's true. I really haven't touched on or talked about tips and tricks when it comes to cool season lawns. So I wanted to make this video to try and address that issue. If you go to our homepage, you'll notice at the top are tabs that say shop by pest, shop by product, lawn and garden, outdoor living equipment, sale, and learn. Let's talk about that last tab. Learn. If you hover over that Learn tab, you'll see a drop-down menu, and on that menu are our lawn care guides. If you click on that, it will take you to our landing page where we have our lawn care schedules for both cool season and warm season. If we click on the lawn care schedules, that will take us to a broad overview of a maintenance calendar for both cool season and warm season grasses. If you scroll down, you'll notice Region 1 encompasses cool season grasses. This will cover the northern United States and cover common cool season grass types like Kentucky bluegrass, annual ryegrass, perennial ryegrass, fine fescue, tall fescue, creeping brent grass, and blends. If you scroll further down, we're looking at Region 2, which is warm season grasses. That's going to be the southern United States, and you're going to be looking at Bermuda grass, blends, buffalo grass, carpet grass, centipede grass, St. Augustine, and zoysia. Even further down that page is Region 3, which is transition grasses. This will be between both cool and warm season zones, and it's going to encompass both types of grasses that are found in both cool and warm season. Back at the top of the page, if you click on the maintenance calendar for cool season grasses, that's going to take you over to our broad overview of when to apply pre-emergence, post-emergence, when to fertilize, mowing, watering, aeration, and dethatching. But let me point something out here. This is just a broad overview of when you should do these applications. This isn't a one-size-fits-all, and it's not going to be exact. Everything's going to depend on your weather, the region you're in. All that kind of stuff is going to play a factor of when you should do these applications. Your pre and post emergence, your fertilizing, your mowing, watering, aeration, dethatching, all of that's really going to depend on what's going on in the area you live in. But it'll give you a general target window of when you should think about doing these applications. And we have the same kind of calendar for warm season grasses on that lawn care schedules page. Back on the landing page of the lawn care guides, we've tried to cover the most common weeds and diseases and even pests that are found in most lawns. If you click on one of those most common weeds or diseases or pests, it's going to open up a guide that talks all about that. Each guide will have four main tabs: identification, inspection, treatment, and prevention. And it's very important that you go through and click in that order so that you can learn how to identify the weed or disease or pest, how to inspect for them, how to treat them, and how to prevent them from getting in your yard. We're continually going back and going through these guides and see how we can improve them and include as much information as possible to empower you to take care of your lawn. The other thing I want to point out here, when we say lawn diseases, we also are talking about lawn fungus. Fungus disease, they're one and the same. Once again, here we covered the five most basic and most common lawn diseases that are out there. So that's it. Just a quick video highlighting our lawn care guides found on domyown.com. The lawn care guide is going to incorporate, again, both cool and warm season grasses and that transitional zone that has a mix of both. Hop on there, click through the guides, and look at all the different tips and tricks that we have in regards to cool and warm season grasses, and also look at those most common weeds, diseases, and pests, and try to learn and educate yourself on what those are. Hope you found this helpful, and I hope you find the lawn care guides helpful as well. Make sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking this button right here, and you can click this playlist to see all the things that we've done in the lawn so far, and also click this playlist to see our Do My Own Gardening series. And as always, thanks for watching.